season, you gotta wonder if these women
wait,
are...
Wait, what the hell is this?
What are you...
Hey!
What are you doing here?
Guys, I tell you what, I'm sorry that I'm late. I was finishing up some business in the back with Eric Bischoff, a couple of final touches, but I'm out here with you guys.
We had enough of you last week.
You know what, but this week I brought something to the table. You're going to be proud of me, something only the coach can do. Because tonight, right here live on Raw, guess what I've done? Mano e mano. That's right, those two men right there, Shawn Michaels, Triple H, in this very ring, as only the coach can do. The main event at the Royal Rumble, last man standing, a live interview with those two men right here tonight, and only I can get it done.
You gotta be kidding. That's pretty damn impressive, quite frankly. If you do get it done.
I don't believe it.
Are you sure?
I am positive.
Joining forces with Chris tonight.
Yeah, more puppies!
Here at Tag Team Action. And I'll tell you what, Coach, you've never had a more important assignment if you really are going to deliver. And I assume that you are. Shawn Michaels and Triple H face to face in this very ring live tonight.
Yeah, JR, you know me about as well as anybody. I always deliver. Do I ever do anything that I say I'm not going to do? I always come through.
You know, there was that one time, Coach, that you remember what I'm talking about.
Well, ladies and gentlemen, last week, let us show you what happened here on Monday Night Raw in a situation where Trish was having her way with the women's champion when Jazz, out of nowhere, made a huge impact. And Jazz assaulting not only Trish, but Jazz having some issues with the women's champion as well.
Well, I talked to Trish earlier tonight. That was very nice, too. And let me tell you something. She is hot. And there you can see the reason why. Oh, there's Jazz.
And I got to believe that, well, we'll tell this story here in a moment.
Introducing her tag team partner from Forest Lake, Minnesota. She is the WWE Women's Champion, Molly Holly.
Got to believe that because of the physicality between Jazz and the women's champion, Molly Holly, that they are somewhat reluctant tag team partners here tonight.
Well, you guys talk about delivering on what is promised. Now, when I look at three of these four women in the ring, with the exception of Molly Holly, three of these four women have delivered on me.
And look at Trish.
Exactly.
One right for Jazz. And
what?
It pairs up Lita and Molly Holly here in this tag team matchup. Jack Doan, the referee, hits his attempt over by Lita. And Trish couldn't wait to get her hands all over Jazz, and that could erupt before this match concludes tonight.
Now, guys, I don't want to brag or anything, but that's just the bottom line, and that's why I'm out here tonight, to take a look at these women up close and personal, but also to help you guys out. I got so many great emails and phone calls that they wanted me back tonight.
Well, all you do, Coach, is brag. Come on, let's be professional. I'm not talking about you all
night. You don't have any right to brag. You're about as welcome out here as a fever blister.
Did you do the ovation for me when I came out?
Got an elbow tie up and Lita. Modified fireman carry takeover on Jazz.
You couldn't get a standing ovation if you sang the national anthem, Coach. Now just get that interview out here that you promised, and maybe, you know, maybe we'll change our mind about it.
Oh, it's definitely going to happen. Don't worry about that. Be patient, my friend. Be patient.
Nice suplex and nip up by Lita on Jazz. All four women in this match have been the women's champion at one time or another. That's got to be everybody's goal. And look, for the referee's back turn, you see Molly taking Lita, maybe hurt that arm, taking Lita off the top turnbuckle.
Hey, the arm a little remiss. You've got Theodore Long at ringside. We've been out here a couple of minutes already. You have not mentioned how great of a job Theodore Long did last Monday night right here on Raw, running the show as a filling in general manager.
There's a good reason for that.
He did a great job.
He was running Raw last week. The last thing I remember, Coach, he was running for his life. Remember when Stone Cold was acting with that ATV?
Huh? Do you think that's funny?
Tag made and the women's champion in.
That was hilarious.
I tried to forget.
As long as it was happening to him.
Well, you think, see?
I've done my best to try to forget last week's broadcast with Theodore Long in charge, quite frankly.
So what you both are saying, that a black man running for the law, running for an ATV, that's not funny. That's just sad.
And Lita caught in that corner. And Molly having some words with the referee. I'm not going there tonight.
No, well, I'm just pointing something out. That's what King said.
I did? I said Theodore Long running from Stone Cold Steve Austin, who, by the way, happens to be the sheriff. So, you know what? Technically, you may be right. That was funny to me. Very amusing.
Lita trying to find out this predicament here and is successful in doing so. Now, Lita Geese from behind. And a referee having his hands full of these ladies in more ways than one. And a cheap shot on Trish on the far side of the ring by the women's champion. Referee's got to restrain Trish. And now the opportunity certainly presents itself for a double team. But it was Molly pulling Lita from the corner. which shows me that there's a little animosity between Molly and Jazz. They didn't take advantage of a double-team opportunity.
Well, these two, they're competitors, King. You know that.
Well, let me ask you this, Coach. You seem to know everything. Why is Theodore Long out here again tonight? Is he going to try to run the show again tonight or what?
No, because Theodore Long wants to support his woman, Jazz. He wants to make sure everything is run correctly.
Referee did not see the tie-in. And the referee can't call what he doesn't see, unfortunately, for Lita. And now Molly and Jazz, at least for the time being, are on the same page. A very competitive playing field for the women here in the here on Raw for the Women's Championship. And Lita's left arm being isolated, debilitated by a very tenacious Jazz who hails from Lafayette, Louisiana. Using those ropes as a springboard, taking down Lita.
And, Coach, you had to know that Jazz was in the arena last week. Why didn't you tell somebody?
I knew she was in the arena. I wasn't going to tell anybody. As we watch this match, it's clear to me, out of the four women in this ring right now, Jazz is clearly the best athlete. You both have to admit that.
And there's a tag.
I don't admit that at all.
Here comes Trish, those right hands, those forearms as well. Those shots on Jazz, who really did that physical number on Trish last week.
Oh, look at this.
Lucas pressed by Trish Stratus, and the right hands hammering down.
Oh!
And Molly Holly, the women's champion, brought in.
Molly, if you want to see an athletic maneuver, check this out, Coach.
Huh? Well, athletic, yes, but lethal, yes. I don't think so.
Oh,
whoa!
Drop kick. Man. The champion knocked through the ropes.
Oh! It's Matrix Reloaded!
Well, Trish has always been that
serious. Spinebuster slam! And Jazz able to fight out and get that left shoulder up.
That's exactly what I'm talking about. Trish can't finish Jazz. Nobody can finish Jazz.
Irish kick in. Jazz, mini Trish coming in. That reverse elbow. Jazz certainly very pugnacious. There's no doubt about that.
Oh, look at this.
And Trish.
We may finish Jazz right there. Get her.
And now Trish in a pinning combination from the head scissors. And the champion, Molly Holly, interrupts and stops the count. That brings Lita in.
Whoa.
And Lita now.
Whoa, look out!
With a modified Lita Piranha taking Molly over the top, and Lita as well, leaving the two legal women in the ring, Jazz and Trish.
Whoa!
Trish reaching back with a
handful of hair.
Handful of hair that time.
That's exactly what it was, a handful of hair.
Long distracting, Trish, and Jazz has got the tights. Jazz has got the tights, and Tina to win.
Here are your winners, Molly Holly and Jazz.
What are you laughing at, Coach?
I admire so much Theodore Long. Hey, wait a second.
Get Theodore Long out
of
there.
You admire Theodore Long now?
He grabs a woman by the head of the hair. What kind of man is that?
Come on, ref.
Theodore Long had to do what he had to do. You saw it. It was obvious.
That's ridiculous and asinine to even allude to.
And look
at another splash. This one really connects it. And Long now. What business is Teddy Long having there holding this one?
They're just trying to send a statement. That's all they're trying to do.
Wait a minute. There's Chris.
Here's the statement going to be sent. Look at this.
Chris Jericho. Mark Henry coming to the aid of his leader, Theodore Long, and now physically assaulting Chris Jericho. And all Jericho is trying to do is put it in Chris.
That's exactly what Jericho gets for laying his hands on the man, Theodore Long. That's what he gets.
Oh, but it's all right for the man, Theodore Long, to lay his hands on a woman like Trish Stratus. That's okay, isn't it?
Only if the man had to. Only if Theodore Long had to. Let's call it like it is.
I cannot believe the way we're starting here. Mark Henry has laid out Chris Jericho, who came down.